Learn about best practices for developing apps with Azure Database for PostgreSQL in this episode of Azure Tips and Tricks. Azure Database for PostgreSQL provides a scalable, highly available, secure, and performant version of PostgreSQL. In this video, you'll see some best practices for developing apps that help to keep your apps performant, secure, and available. The first best practice is to implement the latest security guidelines. You can configure security for PostgreSQL here in the Connection Securities blade. Here you can see that the server firewall is already enabled. This keeps everything from connecting to your PostgreSQL databases, including other Azure services, unless you allow that. I'll add my PC's IP address so that I can connect to the PostgreSQL server from my PC. Another best practice is to set the minimum required version of TLS to 1.2, which means that connecting apps need a TLS 1.2 secure connection. All right. The next best practice is that you should never store secrets, like connection strings, in your application code. An alternative way to retrieve your connection string in your application is to get it from an environment variable. In this Azure App Service web app, you can configure your connection string in the configuration blade, which your application can retrieve as an environment variable without storing it in code. Okay, next. It's very rare, but it can happen that your database goes down. In that case, it is useful to have a replica of your database running in another region. You can use the replication blade to manage database replicas. Here we go. I already have one replica, which gets its data synchronized from my master database continuously. Let's create another one. To create a replica, I also need to create a server, like this. Okay, let's do it. And I'll skip ahead. Here is the replica that I've just created. I can fail over to it when my master database fails and promote it to master, so that my app can read from it and write to it. Next up is the Autovacuum job feature, which you can find in the Server Parameters blade. When this is off, your database grows and slows down, because in PostgreSQL, records are soft deleted, which means that they need to be purged by a vacuum job. And when Autovacuum is enabled, your database regularly performs a vacuum job, which cleans up the database and keeps it running smoothly. Okay, let's move on. Here, in the Query Performance Insights blade, you could see useful query information. To see it, you first need to enable the Query Store feature in PostgreSQL. You can do that in the Server Parameters. Here we go. In here, you need to set the PGQS Query Capture Mode parameter to All, and then save it. After 20 minutes or so, you'll be able to see useful information about your queries. When you use best practices for Azure Database for PostgreSQL, like optimized server security, not storing connection strings in code, use read replications, enable auto vacuum, and use the query store feature, you make sure that your applications will perform at their best and will stay available and secure. Go and check it out.